It's been hailed as one of the scientific discoveries of the past century. Scientists at the CERN Research Centre in Switzerland believe they may have discovered the Higgs boson particle, believed to be the missing link in our understanding of the formation of the universe. The breakthrough is the culmination of more than 40 years of research.
In terms of scientific discovery, it could hardly get bigger than this. At CERN in Geneva, they've discovered the last piece of the puzzle that explains how it is that our universe exists.
As a layman, I would now say, I think we have it. You agree?
Yeah.
In the audience, an apparently emotional Peter Higgs, the man who gave his name to this particle. Almost 50 years ago, he and others had a fantastic idea, a supposition. Today, in his lifetime, it really looks like that theory is true.
Well, for me personally, it's just the confirmation of something that I did 48 years ago, and it's very satisfying to be proved right in some way.
The theory was that there's an invisible force field that enables everything to exist, the stars, the planets, trees, everything, us. Without it, there would be nothing, no structure, no mass, just a blur of whizzing photons and energy.
It means that our understanding of the universe is correct, that we have a complete theory. This was the last piece of the jigsaw, if you like, and it came along. And it came along in a strange way, almost in the last place that it could have hidden from us, almost the last place we looked, if that doesn't sound too tautological. We've actually discovered this thing, and it's part of the model that we have that describes the whole universe.
It's the beginning of a long journey to investigate all the properties of this interesting particle. And this is why everybody is not only excited about the discovery, everybody is also excited about the prospects this discovery opens for us.
This discovery may close one chapter in physics, but it opens so many more. Emma O'Kelly, RTE News.
We're joined here in studio to discuss the significance of all this by Dr. Cormac O'Rafferty, who lectures in physics at Waterford Institute of Technology. Cormac, thanks indeed for coming in to talk to us on the programme. Now, physicists are very excited about this announcement today from Switzerland, from CERN. Why are you so excited?
I suppose it's a combination of very excited and yet sort of satisfied, something that you pretty much thought all along was there, but was very, very hard to find. But it's really nice to have a good news story, and this is a very good day for science. Effectively, the Higgs boson is a particle. We've known for a long time that matter, everything you see around you, is made up of tiny, tiny atoms. Mm-hmm. And within the atom itself is made up of a nucleus and the electron going around it. But within the nucleus of the atom, you have lots and lots of particles. And our best theory for all that hangs together is called the Standard Model of Particle Physics. Now, the thing about that theory is it sounds really theoretical, but it had predicted an enormous number of particles, all of which had been found and ticketed and labelled, but there was one that was outstanding. For the last 50 years almost, really almost 50 years, the Higgs boson, which is a very, very important part of the model, just couldn't be found. And I was delighted to see Professor Ronan McNulty on earlier. His group do great work in CERN. It's a group based in UCD. Yeah. And he was talking about how they close windows. And that's right. The professionals always say that. It's all about closing windows. And unfortunately, the Higgs turned out to be in almost the very last window they looked.
And its significance, we're being told today, is that it's the particle that holds everything together. Yeah. The furniture around here, the studio set.
In a sense, yeah. It's associated with a field called the Higgs field. And effectively, it's a little bit like a field of snow. Different people moving through snow will interact differently with the snow. Some will go very quickly if they're on skis. Other will be a bit slowed down if they're a bit heavier and they're tromping through the snow. Well, the way in which other particles interact with the Higgs field is the way we think that gives them different masses. So it's what makes them different. It's what makes the proton different from the electron, etc.
And they have discovered this by firing particles and colliding them. This is the collider.
That's right. This is the famous
piece of equipment beneath the ground in Switzerland.
The Large Hadron Collider. It's a large collider which collides hadrons. Yeah. Hadrons is just a type of particle. And just as Einstein predicted all those years ago, what happens is if you take, in this case it's protons, but if you take two particles of matter and you slam them together as hard as you can, what happens is it's not that the Higgs boson is inside it. Instead, you create an energy, the energy of that collision. And out of that energy, you can create new matter. And one of the things you create is the Higgs particle. Now, they couldn't see it directly. I shouldn't say that. That would be misleading. But what they do see is the Higgs then decays into other particles. And both two different groups, two independent groups of CERN, have seen the decay products in two different channels. Yeah. So let's say it's, I wouldn't quite say beyond a shadow of a doubt, but as Ralph Hoyer said this morning, it's pretty much, as far as the rest of the world is concerned, it's there. For the physicists, it's now to investigate it.
In terms of some practical consequences from this, I mean, obviously there's the satisfaction, presumably, for physicists that this theory has been proved. But for the rest of us, are there practical consequences that...
Yeah, that's right. I mean, there's two. One is there's always, in the future, fundamental research almost always has huge knock-on effects later on. But the most immediate one is always in the search for these things. And funny enough, I was just listening to the terrible Ulster Bank story tonight, and it's the ongoing saga. And actually today, I would say, the biggest victory, even though there were thousands of people involved all around the world, the biggest victory is for computing. I mean, I think this result is probably 3 or 4 months earlier than most people expected, including most of the professionals. And that's because of the new, what they call grid computing system they put in place, where computers all around the world were linked up, more or less working in tandem. And with that new system, they were able to analyse the data extremely quickly. Now, in a few years, that'll be used in banks around the world, for example.
And what's next then? Presumably, this is
a very good question.
Theoretical physics.
I think, as the physicists all put it, I think it closes one chapter very nicely, we think anyway, but it also opens a whole new chapter. And that's because we think already from where it is, there are already hints that the standard model, the theory I talked about of matter, everything we see around, the standard model isn't in fact complete. Now, by studying the properties of the Higgs property, of the Higgs boson or the Higgs particle, by looking at it carefully, that will tell us a lot about what's coming up next. In particular, there's a whole family of particles that a lot of people think maybe they are called supersymmetric particles, and this is the starting point. So it's the start of it. It's the start of a whole new chapter.
So the closer you look, the more you see, and the less you realise you know.
Well, isn't that always the way? And you never know where it's going to lead you.
Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you very much, Ben.
Thank you.